we received this box from ASUS. This is the all-new Zenbook S14 and it has the latest Intel Core Ultra Series 2 chipset, and this laptop is very special. Because when I tested the Snapdragon X Elite laptop, I was really surprised to see it destroying MacBook Air. But after using this laptop for over 3 weeks, I can say this loud and clear. This laptop destroys both MacBook and Snapdragon like a pro. Yes, Intel has completely redesigned the CPU architecture this time by simplifying the CPU cores, improving the GPU, upgrading the NPU, and even adding RAM directly to the package to make the chipset as power efficient as possible. And when I tested this laptop thoroughly, it breezes through any tasks I throw at it, scores well in benchmarks, doesn't heat up at all, and I never had to charge it every day. And yeah, it even let me game on it, which both MacBook and Snapdragon laptops struggle at. But let's take it one by one and start with the specs. This laptop comes with the latest Intel Core Ultra 7 258V chipset that has 4 performance cores with a boost clock speed of 4.8 GHz and 4 low power efficiency cores clocked at 3.7 GHz. Since there is no multi-threading this time, you only get 8 threads. The Intel Arc 140V GPU is clocked at 1.95 GHz with 8 XE2 cores, and the NPU is now upgraded to 47 TOPS. There's also 32GB RAM directly on the package itself, just like an SoC, so it's not upgradable, but you do get 1TB Gen 4 SSD, which can be upgraded. I know, it's a lot of specs, but it's a big leap from Intel's previous chipset, so it's important that you guys know all about it. Plus, it shows really well in day-to-day usage as well. Before talking about the performance, I just want to tell you that I got almost 12 hours of daily usage on this one with 72Wh battery inside. When I was using Slack, Notion, editing thumbnails, a bit of YouTube on my breaks, and a lot of Chrome tabs running in the background, the battery life was actually on par with Snapdragon X Elite laptops, which I honestly didn't expect because x86 is not as power efficient as ARM-based processor. And what surprised me the most is that when I was binge watching my favorite TV show on a Sunday, this laptop didn't die on me until it crossed the 15-hour mark. This laptop is even better at binging than me, you, and both combined. And being an x86 laptop, I didn't have to compromise on any applications like I had to on Snapdragon X Elite laptops. I was able to use all the Adobe apps, local send, and I was even able to play all the Windows games. Yes, the Arc 140V GPU works very well, and I got about 200 FPS in Valorant at lower settings in the default 3K resolution, and you can even play demanding titles such as Cyberpunk and Hogwarts Legacy at a decent FPS even with the ray tracing. That is really cool for a laptop without a dedicated GPU. Even in benchmarks, the jump in single core performance is evident in Geekbench and Cinebench, but the multi-core scores are less this time around because of the fewer performance cores in this model. The GPU scores are also pretty good in Geekbench and 3D Mark, and in PC Mark 2, it scores above 6000, and finally the SSD scores are also on point. And the NPU now has enough TOPS to qualify as Copilot Plus PC, unlike last generation Intel laptops. But now, the NPU gets triggered in Windows Studio Effects, and I was able to run Stable Diffusion on the NPU too. That's an improvement, but you'll get more AI features down the line. Not just that, the thermals have also improved this time with dual fan inside, and you get these cool CNC milled vents above the keyboard for better flow, so the temperatures are always in check even under full load. This was not the case when I tested the Intel Core Ultra 7 155H. See, in short, this new CPU is a big jump for Intel, and it gives them a big advantage over the competition in 2024. The performance is top-notch, the battery life has improved a lot, the overheating issue doesn't exist anymore, and yeah, app compatibility was always Intel's thing. So yeah, the game is still on. Alright, let's talk about the rest of the laptop. First of all, the design looks effortlessly stunning. I mean, the design stands out easily. With this minimal branding on the cell aluminium lid, it's a mixture of ceramic and aluminium, and this helps it to be more rigid. Plus, this texture also prevents fingerprints or smudges, which is really cool. The laptop is also well built throughout. There's no flex or screen wobble. It's also very thin and light, and ASUS even bundles its very good sleeve to carry it around. By the way, you don't need to carry a dongle because you get an HDMI 2.1, 2 Thunderbolt 4 ports, a 3.5mm jack on the left, and a lonely USB A 3.2 Gen 2 port on the right. And when you open this laptop with one finger, you are greeted with this gorgeous display. It's a stunning 3K 16x10 OLED display with 120Hz refresh rate, 500 nits of peak brightness, and Dolby Vision support. It's very color accurate for productivity tasks and even movie watching. It's a glossy panel, but I never found myself increasing the brightness unless it's for a movie. I watched a couple of Dolby Vision movies movies on Netflix, and the screen looks amazing paired with the quad speakers tuned by Harman Kardon, and they are Dolby Atmos certified too. They're downward facing, but it gets really loud and there's decent bass too. The display also has VRR support, and with 0.2 milliseconds response time and 120Hz refresh rate, the panel is very good for gaming too. When you want to get some actual work done, the 16x10 screen helps in showing more content, and it's pretty sharp to look at these rectangles. Plus, you can also scroll through them like this. Yeah, it's a touch panel. By the way, if you're wondering, you do get MS Office 21, but there's no McAfee, which is really good. Plus, as an Intel Evo laptop, the wake up time is instant. For typing, the keys are well spaced and have 1.1 mm key travel, and I really like how good the feedback is. There's also white backlit, which can turn on automatically, as there's a brightness sensor for adjusting both the backlit and the screen brightness. And now, if I talk about the trackpad, it is glass and works well with regular Windows gestures, and you also get smart gestures with which you can adjust the sound, screen brightness, and scroll through videos like this. Plus, when you're in a meeting, you will look sharp with this 1080p webcam, which also supports IR face unlock, and you also get these studio effects, which I mentioned earlier. Lastly, you get the latest Wi-Fi 7 and Bluetooth 5.4, and this laptop comes with a 65W Type-C adapter, which charges the laptop to 60% in just 45 minutes, which is pretty good. And as for the pricing, the variant that we have with us costs 1,49,990 rupees. I know, it's expensive, but it's not overpriced in my opinion because of the features it comes with. You get a very powerful and power efficient processor packed with an amazing display, a cool design, and a great overall experience. But I do wish ASUS also releases an affordable Beebom series with the same chipset. So what do you guys think about the all new ASUS Zenbook S14 laptop with Intel Core Ultra 2 series chipset? Tell us in comments, and I'll see you in the next one.